Welcome to the third section in our series on protein. This section is covering the digestion and absorption of protein. Now, this section is going to be short, and I'm just going to cover the basic aspects of protein digestion and absorption. Remember, digestion is the breakdown of food into individual nutrients, and absorption is taking those nutrients, those individual nutrients, and pulling them into the bloodstream. We're going to start with protein. Remember, this is our very complex protein structure coiled and folded on itself. And once the protein goes into the stomach, there's a very low pH, as I mentioned before. That pH of 2 is necessary to uncoil that protein. So all these coils here are basically, they're uncoiled, they're unfolded, and you end up with this strand of amino acids. Now remember, each of these circles represents just one amino acid. So this is a string of amino acids. And in addition to that, there's actually an acid-stable protein, pepsin, which exists in the stomach, and that can cleave the really long chains of protein down into smaller polypeptides. Now once it goes from the stomach into the small intestines, there are enzymes released from the pancreas and the intestinal lining, like I mentioned earlier. These enzymes will take the polypeptide chain and break down that chain of amino acids into smaller dipeptides and tripeptides. So these are just, this is just a 2 amino acid unit, and this is a 3 amino acid unit. Enzymes again will then break down these di and tripeptides into individual amino acids. Now, once we have these individual amino acids, this is in the intestine, this is, let me orient you, this is the intestines, this is the intestinal cells, and then they're attached to the bloodstream. Once the amino acids go from the protein to being uncoiled, to the polypeptide, to the dipeptide, tripeptide, and then become these individual amino acids, they are then absorbed into the bloodstream. So across the intestinal cell lining and into the bloodstream. And that is the end of our section on digestion and absorption of protein.